Sir, we are going live. Just wait a second. I will tell you.
Yeah.
You can start.
Yeah. Namaskar. Good morning to all of you. I welcome all of you to this 11th lecture of MOES webinar series on the basics of weather forecasting, including observation. At the outset, I wish to express my sincere thanks to the Secretary, Ministry of Earth Science, for kindly giving me this opportunity. And also, I wish to express my sincere thanks to the Director General of Meteorology for kindly recommending my name for this talk. So now, I will start my presentation of my talk, Basics of Weather Forecasting, including observation. I tried to make my presentation in a very, very basic way. So many operational meteorologists, experts may find it's very, very trivial. However, my purpose is to make it in a very, very basic way. So now, I will just share the screen to my presentation slides. Presentation slide. Basics of weather forecasting, including observation. So, first of all, before weather forecasting, let us understand in a very simple way, what do we understand by weather? Weather at any place, at any time, is the atmospheric condition prevailing there at that time. It is generally expressed as how cold or how hot is, how dry or how humid is, whether it is raining or not raining. So therefore, we can understand that weather condition at a place is expressed in terms of certain weather parameter like air temperature, humidity, rain, etc. And at a given location, weather condition may vary from time to time. That means at your location, weather in the morning may be something, at 10 o'clock it may be something, in the noon time it may be something, evening it may be something, at the night it may be something. Even at a given time, weather may vary from different place to place. At 10 o'clock, whether at Mumbai, whether at Pune, whether at Aurangabad, whether at Kolkata, whether at Ahmedabad, it may be different. Importance of weather is very much well known to all of us. Weather condition affects our transport activities by disrupting transport activities. A bad weather condition may compel postponement of takeoff or not able to land at desired point. Agricultural loss due to damage of crop by heavy rainfall, snow, a hailstone. Then weather condition many times gives rise to break of viral diseases. Weather condition may lead to water scarcity or water logging, power breakdown, inconvenience to general public. Many times our plan we need to postpone. Then postponement of reschedule or rescheduling of community function, just like some party, marriage party or something. And not only that, weather condition also affects the relief activities of the disaster management team, which we have seen recently in Bombay and in Kolkata due to the two storms. When these disaster relief people, they were busy for the COVID affected people. That time these two storms very much affected their activities. These are the different natural hazards. Generally, we in India we face drought, forest fire, earthquake, flood, heat wave, cold wave, landslide, cyclone in two seasons, heavy rainfall or flash floods during the monsoon season, southwest monsoon season and the northeast monsoon season, and thunderstorm in most parts of the country. So these are different natural hazards, and you can see that most of the natural hazards which we have seen in the previous slide, these are caused by weather. So now, what are the basic weathers we face in India in different season? In winter, January, February, major weather is western disturbance, cold, wave, fog, heavy snow, frost. Pre-monsoon, that is March, April, May, we face with cyclonic disturbances, heat wave, thunderstorm, squalls, hailstorm, monsoon. Southwest monsoon season, heavy rainfall, floods due to heavy and droughts if there is subdued rainfall. And post-monsoon season, October, November, December, we face cyclonic disturbances and heavy rainfall due to northeast monsoon season, which we have seen a couple of years back in Chennai. This is a schematic diagram to show different weather systems affecting India. You can see this is your western disturbance. This is your western disturbance in the form of wave, then thunderstorm, then monsoon low during monsoon season, cyclonic disturbance, offshore vortices, offshore trap, mid-tropospheric cyclonic circulation, then easterly wave. These are all different types of weather which has been shown in this picture schematically in different seasons. There are varieties of phenomena, weather phenomena occurring in our atmosphere having different space and time scale. For that, you can see this picture. Dust devil, cumulus cloud, severe storm, cold front, monsoon. Now for monsoon, what is the time scale? You can see it is of the scale, time scale is of the month. And what is the scale, horizontal scale, 10,000 kilometer. Now suppose severe storm, it is of the order of one day. And what is the scale, horizontal dimension, spatial dimension, this is your 10 kilometer, like that. These are different atmospheric systems having different space and time scales. So we have seen what is weather, how it affects in different aspects of our life, how it affects different societal sectors. So therefore we can understand that it is very much essential to know in advance about the occurrence of such weather phenomena. And this is your weather forecasting. Weather forecasting, technically, it is a method which enables us to tell the future condition of the atmosphere or state of the atmosphere at a given place at a given future time. Advanced information about weather condition along with the expected hazards, we all can realize it is immensely useful for the planners, for the policy makers, even to the general public, for all the sectors. It helps the farmers to plan when to plant their crops, when to harvest them. It helps the pilot to know when to take off, when to land, and whether to reroute, whether to change his route or not. It helps the sailors at sea to schedule their journeys. Also, it helps the people to plan what to put on for the day, whether to carry umbrella or not, all this thing. And it helps the government to make contingency plan if required. What is the history of weather forecasting? Well, realizing the adverse effect of the weather, long back there was attempt to foretell about the future weather. There is certain history I have taken. Around 650 BC, the Babylonians tried to predict short-term weather changes based on the appearance of clouds, optical phenomena such as halos. By 300 BC, Chinese astronomers had developed a calendar dividing the entire year into 24 festivals, and each festival was associated with a different type of weather. Around 340 BC, the Greek philosopher Aristotle wrote Meteorologica, which included theories about the formation of rain, clouds, hail, wind, thunder, lightning, hurricanes. Then modern forecasting age, we can say, after the invention of electric telegraph, two main should be mentioned, who to be given the credit, due to whom forecasting appeared as a science. There your one is Beaufort, Francis Beaufort, another Robert Fitzroy. Beaufort developed the wind force scale and weather course, and Fitzroy's warning service for shipping was initiated in February 1861 with the use of telegraph communications. The first daily weather forecast was published in the Times in 1861, and in the following year, a system was introduced of wasting storm warning cones at the principal ports when a gale was expected. Still now, similar practice we are following. And this is a typical weather map of Europe, December 10, 1887. History of weather services in IMD. Early philosophical writings of the 3000 BC era, such as Upanishads, contain serious discussion about the processes of cloud formation and rain and the seasonal cycles caused by the movement of the earth around the sun. Brahmi's classical work, the Brihaspatisamhita, written around 500 AD, provides a clear evidence that a deep knowledge of atmospheric processes existed then even. It was understood that rains come from the sun, Aditya Jayate Vrishti, and this is the logo of India Meteorological Department, and that good rainfall in the rainy season was the key to bountiful agriculture and food for the people. Kautilya's Arthashastra contains records of scientific measurements of rainfall and its application to the country's revenue and the relief work. Kalidasa, in his epic Meghdoot, written around the 7th century, mentions the date of onset of the monsoon over central India and traces the path of the monsoon clouds. British East India Company established observatories at Calcutta in 1785 and Madras, now known as Chennai, in 1796. Asiatic Society of Bengal, founded in 1784 at Calcutta and 1804 at Bombay, promoted scientific studies in meteorology in India. Captain Harry Paddington at Calcutta published 40 papers during 1835 to 1855 in the Journal of the Asiatic Society dealing with tropical storms, and he coined the word cyclone, meaning the coil of a snake. In the first half of the 19th century, several observatories began functioning in India under the provincial government. And in the telegraph age, IMD made extensive use of weather telegrams for collecting observational data and sending warnings. Later, IMD became the first organization in India to have a message switching computer for supporting its global data exchange. One of the first few electronic computers introduced in the country was provided to IMD for the scientific application in meteorology. And India was the first developing country in the world to have its own geostationary satellite INSAT for continuous weather monitoring of this part of the globe, and particularly for the cyclone warning. After discussion of this history of this forecasting, now let me discuss with you what are the different types of forecaster there. Generally, forecaster divided or categorized based on the time and spatial scale, which I have shown in that picture. Nowcast for next few hours. It is venue and location specific. Short range for 24 to 72 hours. Location and district, state or met subdivision, subdivision specific. Then quantitative medium range forecast for 3 days to 3 to 7 days, city, district and block specific. Extended range prediction for 4 weeks. It is for met subdivision, state and homogeneous regions. And long range prediction, this is for homogeneous region, country. Earlier it was homogeneous region and country. Now it is for the entire India. And it is for July and August and temperature for the season also. And red colors, whatever I have shown here, these are basically additional activities in 2016. These are the different sectoral sectors who uses the weather forecasting: aviation, marine, road and rail transport, agriculture, water management, tourism, industry, planners, general public, health, then your disaster management, power industry, disaster management, water industry. Now, so we have understood what is weather, what are the different time, what are the types of weather, what are the importance. Now for weather, and we also understood that the need of the weather forecasting. Now, and we have seen the weather need of the weather forecasting, even it was felt long, long back, and they tried at their level best during that time. So now what are the needs for, what are the essential requirements for weather forecasting jobs? The first and foremost thing is qualified and trained human resource, very robust observational system network, which consists of surface, upper air, automated observation, then remote sense observation like satellite radar, then there should be means for exchange and communication. Once upon a time it was telegram, now it is internet. Computational capability, high performance computing system, which MOES is having. Then platform for analysis of available information, all available information by overlying one or other. In India Meteorological Department, we are having such a platform, that is Synergy system and effective display system. Observational system, this is a schematic diagram of the observational system. You can see in this observational system, it is you can see in the observational system, this is your surface observation, this is your upper air station, satellite, aircraft, buoy, ocean observations, everything is there. Okay, so these are the components: surface, upper air, marine, aircraft base, satellite, weather radar observations. And for forecasting of the weather, observation of certain daily weather parameters are made in every weather station. These are your atmospheric pressure. This is nothing but the weight of an air column above a point with unit cross section extending from that point up to top of the atmosphere, and it is measured by a barometer. We can see the picture also. Wind, this is nothing but air in motion, its direction and speed. And this is instrument uses wind vane, cup anemometer, it is shown here. Wind vane gives you the wind vane and both of the, and both, and there is another one instrument, Dines Petit, a pressure type anemometer. It gives you the wind and pressure both. Then temperature, for that thermometer, you can, this is a typical picture of Stevenson screen. There are four thermometers are there: maximum temperature, minimum temperature, dew point temperature, dry bulb temperature. All these parameters are observed. Then humidity, it gives you the availability information about availability of water vapor in the atmosphere. The instrument used is hygrometer, air hygrometer. And precipitation, it is nothing but a rain, drizzle, hail, etc. For that rain gauge we are using. Sunshine recorder, this refers to the energy received from the sun. We use sunshine recorder. And for cloud, it refers the coverage and type of the cloud. that is for the accelerometer we are using. Now, what are the different types of weather forecasting? It may broadly be categorized into three major types. One is your traditional synoptic method, then statistical method, then dynamical method. The synoptic method, basically, it's a suite of a couple of tasks, which starts from taking observation over the entire globe simultaneously at some fixed time. These times are expressed in terms of Greenwich Mean Time or Universal Time Coordinate. These times are known as synoptic hours of observation. So therefore, at a given 00 GMT, observations are taken at Delhi, it is taken at Pune, it is taken at England also, and taken at Australia and every country. Then once, after taking these observations, coded messages for these observations, observed informations are prepared. This is the earlier practice. Nowadays we don't do. Then the coded messages among, because nowadays we can send it by the direct observation, we can send it by email also, but coded message also we can send it. Then exchange of coded messages among all centers for weather forecasting. Whatever observation is made at Pune, then after preparation of coded message of that observation, it is being sent to other centers. Similarly, we are also receiving coded message of weather observation from other centers also. After receiving of the coded messages, they are being decoded, and decoded weather elements are plotted on the weather charts. Weather elements are nothing but wind, temperature, pressure, cloud, etc. on the weather charts for the respective. Once the plotting is over, then analysis of the chart is being done. Analysis is nothing but drawing of lines, joining those points having equal values of a certain parameter. When we analyze a pressure chart, that time we draw lines joining all those points, all those centers, all those stations having a given pressure value. Similarly for temperature. Now once analysis is completed, then it is possible to identify the regions having maximum value of certain parameter or minimum value of certain that parameter, even a transition zone where maximum is getting changed to minimum or minimum is getting changed to maximum. So these are known as synoptic features. Now once the chart analysis is done, forecasters first identify the synoptic features, and forecaster through his knowledge, through his experience, through his training, his or her knowledge, experience and training knows which weather is associated with which type of synoptic feature, and accordingly forecast is. For example, a forecaster knows that cold wave and fog occurs over a station once a western disturbance passed away through it. Western disturbance is a synoptic feature. Now by seeing the synoptic feature, he applies his knowledge, and accordingly he or she gives a forecast that cold wave or fog occurs over a station. Accordingly, a synoptic weather forecast bulletin is issued. However, although this method is a very traditional, since for a long time we are using it, is a very tested method, but still this method suffers with certain limitation. This method can give forecast for a broad region, for a broad period. It involves a lot of subjectivity, like knowledge, experience of the forecaster, which may vary from forecaster to forecaster for a given weather phenomena. And another one limitation is that location and time specific forecast is difficult from this method, which is nowadays it's a demand. Everybody wants a location and time specific forecast, which is not possible using synoptic method of forecasting. Next thing is statistical method. In the statistical method, we use past data of long period. We call it a time series. Past data means minimum 30 years data for the variable to be forecasted. variable which we want to forecast, we call it predictant, and the variables which are used for its prediction purpose, this is called predictors. So in this method, what we do, we take the known value of the predictant and predictors for past long period, and using these values, statistical association which we call it correlation between each of the predictors and predictant is computed, and then a mathematical equation is established between the predictant and those predictors having significant statistical association, and this mathematical relation we generally call it regression equation. So, and this is called a regression model. And then once this regression equation is set up, then this equation we may use it for the forecast of that predictant for some future time. Long range forecast of Indian summer monsoon rainfall issued by IMD was initially based on this technique only. Although, of course, nowadays also this technique is in vogue in IMD. However, this method also suffers with certain difficulties. One thing is that what correlation I mentioned between the predictors and the predictant, it changes from place to place, season to season. Even for a given place and time, correlation and regression coefficient, it changes with time. Suppose I have set up a regression equation based on 30 years data, say from 1961 to 1990. Okay, it is good when I am using it for 1901. But if I want to use it for 1995, then again you need to fine tune the regression coefficients. What I mean to say that means coefficients in the regression equation need to be again fine-tuned using additional data. Okay, so that is a problem. And another one thing is also there, statistical method is always very good for predicting mean. However, there are difficulties while forecasting extremes. Now, after realizing the difficulties in the statistical method and the synoptic method, scientists started thinking in a different way, that whether a robust method can be developed for the location and specific time specific forecast, and that gives the birth of the numerical weather prediction. So before numerical weather prediction, I would like to tell you what is the history of numerical weather prediction. In 1904, V. Bartnes first realized that the problem of forecasting weather is an initial value problem. By initial value problem, he tried to refer that it's a problem of telling about the future value of an unknown quantity, provided I know its present value. And provided I know a rule for the time evolution of that unknown variable. If these two things are available, one thing is I must know what are the present value of the unknown quantity, and I must know a rule for the temporal evolution, that means how with time that unknown quantity changes, that rule I must know. If I know, then it is possible to tell the future value of that unknown variable. This problem in mathematical literature, we generally call it an initial value problem. In 1920, L.F. Richardson attempted to solve the governing equations. Governing equations are nothing but the rules for temporal evolution of different meteorological variables like pressure, temperature, wind, etc., for predicting the 24 hours pressure change using a DEX computer. However, he failed as the computed 24 hours pressure change was a several order of magnitude greater than the observed 24 hours pressure change. And our failure may be attributed to the use of unfiltered input data. Afterwards, in 1950, a group of three scientists formed in Princeton University, United States, Neumann, Fortoft, and Czerny, and they developed an NWP model. And in the history of NWP model, it is the first operationally successful NWP model which could forecast the height of 500 HPL level. And afterwards, NWP need not to look back during its forward march. Now, for NWP, there is a basic realization is there that weather at any place, at any time, is dependent, rather a function of seven basic meteorological variables. What are those? They are nothing but the three components of the wind. One is your east-west component, which we call technically zonal component. Another one is your north-south component. We call it meridional component. Another one is your up-down component, which we call vertical component. These three components of the wind, then pressure, then temperature, then density and humidity. So if at a given time, at a place, if I know the values of these seven variables, then it is possible to get the weather at that time, at that place, by setting up of a relation, functional relation, mathematical relation between them and the concerned weather. So the problem of forecasting weather has been translated to the problem of forecasting the future values of these seven variables. This is the philosophy of NWP. So, and this is a broad structure of a NWP model. I have just drawn it. The first one is your input. In this input, all sorts of information, all sorts of observational information comes from all sources. Upper air, surface, synoptic, asynoptic, regular, non-regular, satellite, radar, all these things. Then your ship observation, okay, synoptic observation, asynoptic observation, all observation comes into this input. Now, since the input data cannot be directly ingested in the model, because input data may contain lot of errors due to many reasons, so they need to be pre-processed. So there is a pre-processing unit is there. Input data straight away sent to pre-processing unit. In the pre-processing unit, lot of quality checks are done as prescribed by WMO. Then not only that, gridded data is formed, then errors are removed, all these things. And after pre-processing is completed, then pre-processed data sent to the model, and in the model, I will discuss what is there. And after that, there is a model output. That means after model integration, all the output value means that future value of the seven parameter, it will come here. And but as the model output cannot be directly given to the stakeholder because it is of no use by the stakeholders. So again, it need to be post-processed. So there is a post-processing unit is there. After post-processing unit only, post-processed data, given it to the stakeholders in a display method. So this is now future value of any one of these seven variables can be, I told you that the problems of weather forecasting has been translated to the problem of forecasting these seven variables. So now forecast of these seven variables is possible if I know its present value, which is known as initial condition, and if we have a rule which are known as governing equation, which tells us about its change with time and the factors responsible for its change. And fortunately, in the meteorology literature, we have 7, we have rules for each of these 7 variables in the form of some equation, and those equation we call governing equations. And those equations, by nature, they are nonlinear partial differential equation. And also through observation followed by required quality checks and pre-processing, we have the necessary initial condition for the 7 variables. So therefore, in principle, ideally, NWP has the capability of giving location and time-specific forecast. So as I told you, pre-processing of the input data is carried out, as direct observation cannot be directly fed up. Governing equations, as I told, they are solved mathematically using high power performance computing system. Similar predicted future values of these 7 variables, they are processed according to the needs of the customer. Customer means, I mean, to the stakeholder. And so we can understand this method is capable of giving location and time specific forecast. In any case, forecast is forecast. No forecast can say that it is 100% perfect. It can give the 100% accurate forecast. So there is always a chance, maybe very small, of forecast failure. This is nothing but your forecast uncertainty. And forecast uncertainty may be estimated and expressed in terms of the probability. So, in a simple way, we can say that suppose there is a weather, and that weather is being attempted to forecast by a number of forecasters or number of forecasting system, or a single forecaster by number of forecast methods, and forecasts are generated. Now once the forecasts are generated, then now what happened? Instead of one forecast for a given time, for a given location, I am having now a sample of forecast. Now once I am having a sample of forecast, I am free to do a lot of statistics on that. I can find out the mean of this, mean of all these forecasts, what are the standard deviation, and I can also find out probability of different forecasts. Okay, so and it is very, very useful if the forecast along with the forecast information about the forecast uncertainty also passed on to the planners and policymakers so that they can tune their plan accordingly. Now, this forecast uncertainty problem has given rise to another one forecasting method. This is a combination of dynamical and statistical method. This method is known as ensemble prediction system. I am not an expert in ensemble prediction system. I am trying to explain ensemble prediction system as I explained. It's a group or a sample of many NWP forecasts. The NWP forecast I am having, but I don't have a single NWP forecast for a given weather. I am having a group of forecasts. And why we should use it? As I told you, that is to quantify the uncertainties in the forecast. And what we do in the APS? In the APS, we do, instead of running a given NWP model once using a single initial condition, it may be run many times using different initial conditions which are varying very little to each other. This is number one. Another one thing also we can do, that initial, using the same initial condition, many NWP models may run and they can generate many forecasts. So in any case, I got a number of forecasts for a given weather system, for a particular place, for a particular future time. So now, if different forecasts in the ensembles are very much similar, then confidence will be more. And if they diverge, then naturally confidence will be less. And this is the two case here. Initial condition is same. This F1, F2, F3, F4, F6, these are different forecasting system. you can say they are different models, different models. So different models are run using the same initial condition. And these are the forecast trajectory. So these are the forecasts, end forecast. These are end forecasts. Now, and it may be this one also. So now you see, in this case, all the end forecasts, they are very much scattered, very much diverse. But here we can see in this case that except this one, most of the forecasts, they are converging at one place. So therefore, in this case, confidence will be more, uncertainty will be less. And in this case, confidence will be less, uncertainty will be more. This is case one. Case two is that, that is, suppose model is only one model is there, only one model, but what happened? Initial condition, the initial condition, from a given initial condition, a many initial condition has been prepared, and all the initial conditions are enclosed within a very small circle, and using each initial condition, forecasts are generated. That now in this case you can see all the forecasts are diverging themselves. So here confidence is less, and here most of the forecasts, they are converging. So it is confidence is more, uncertainty is less. Then I tried to explain schematically in a simple way the concept of EPS. Now, what are the general product of EPS? Ensemble mean, as I told, mean standard deviation. Standard deviation is known as ensemble spread. This is a picture. It is shown here. And the probability. And the probability also it gives. So this is the general thing I told you. Now I will tell you what are the weather forecasting and warning services of IMD. Because we all know that India Meteorological Department is a nodal government agency for public weather forecasting and warning services. So that's why I will discuss in brief the weather forecasting and warning services of IMD. It is a succession of following tasks. First one is to clearly understand the recent development and actual condition of the atmosphere at all time scales, which this is weather analysis. Then to obtain the pertinent information from numerical models, observational systems, satellite, radar, and to assess the future evolution of the atmosphere in order to determine the most likely scenario. Then to deduce the consequences of the expected synoptic situation in terms of weather elements, that is nothing but your weather elements forecasting, and to evaluate the risks of the occurrence of the hazardous phenomena, that is risk assessment, and to prepare the meteorology related information, which we call weather warning. This is to be directed towards the various internal and external users. You can see these are the different types of observations: surface, upper air, space base. All observation they come here as an initial condition. Using this initial condition, initial condition comes here. This is the initial condition comes here, which I told input, and all these input data. Using all these input data, model runs, and these are numerical forecasts are generated. And this numerical forecast, it goes to forecaster, and forecaster also gives a feedback. And then forecaster, after the post-processing and all this thing, it goes to the it is end forecast, and then it goes to the decision maker. After decision maker, it goes to action. And in the model runs, you can see runs of different models, as I told, ensemble, consecutive run from the same model, which I discussed. That means ensemble. Monitoring process. IMD's monitoring process consists of observational network like land-based, surface, and upper air stations. It is given here in the picture. Then observation from Doppler weather radar. You can see this is the network of the Doppler weather radar. Entire coast is covered. Over. Data from geostationary orbiting satellite and polar orbiting satellite. And observation from sea, buoys, etc. Okay. And this is some typical example of satellite products of monitoring fog and cyclone dust storms. It has been shown here. IMD's forecasting system, following methods are used, not a single method. One is your statistical technique, which consists of analog. Analog means similarity. Persistence. Persistence means we see the last 12 hours how it has done. Then attempted to say the next few hours also it will follow the previous track or previous performance. Then climatology, because for every weather phenomena we have a climatology. For climatology, suppose from climatology, climatology tells us during post monsoon season over a certain grid box, if a low pressure forms, whether it can intensify or not. If it intensifies, in which direction climatologically it moves, and in to which course it has strike, etc. Then synoptic method, satellite technique, radar technique, numerical weather prediction, and dynamical statistical model means EPS. EPS and model output statistics, other things are also downscaling and other things also. Medium range weather forecasting system in IMD MOS, global forecasting system GFS of 12 kilometer resolution forecast up to 10 days, then unified model horizontal resolution of 12 kilometer forecast up to 10 days, then GFS is also there, global ensemble forecast system, global probabilistic model resolution 12 kilometer forecast up to 10 days, and all these GFS and GFS model have perform outstandingly during the prediction of recent cyclones. Then unified model ensemble prediction system, this is horizontal resolution 12 kilometer and forecast up to 10 days. And for short range or nowcasting, these are the system: WRF mesoscale model 3 kilometer to 9 kilometer resolution forecast up to 3 days, hurricane WRF for cyclone prediction, multi-model ensemble model based on for cyclone track prediction. Also, there is a suite of dynamical statistical model for the prediction of genesis potential for tropical cyclone. Then storm surge, we are having IMD nomogram. Long back, some it was developed in IMD. Then IIT Delhi, they have developed. Then INQUISE Hyderabad model. And for nowcast and very short range forecast, hourly venue specific for a WRF 3 kilometer and ARPS model with assimilation of Doppler weather radar. This is a very important system in IMD. This is decision support system. Analysis, prediction, decision making process is made by blending scientifically based conceptual models, dynamical model, statistical models, methodological data set, technology and expertise. This is further supported by modern graphical and GIS applications for producing high quality analysis and forecast products, which includes analysis of all synoptic information, satellite, radar, NWP model products for the genesis, intensity, track monitoring and prediction, then preparation, past weather and forecast up to 120 hours. Then depiction of the uncertainty in the forecast based on probabilistic assessment. So this is our IMD's decision support system. It consists of these are the things. IMD's gives a public weather service. It is a three-tier forecasting structure. Features of national level issued by Delhi, then regional level issued by 6 regional meteorological centers located at Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Bombay, Nagpur, Guwahati. And it is issued for the agriculture sector, aviation, shipping, transport means highway and railway, power and energy, tourism, health, sports, disaster management, defense, pilgrim, mountaineering, fisheries, urban development, etc. Day by day, that is demand from IMD is increasing, and IMD is we are very happy to meet the requirement of the government and the public and the sector. And forecast, earlier it was 3 days, now it is 5 days for Met subdivision wise, 24 hours to 5 days sector, 24 hours to 5 days sector wise forecast for mountain, 24 hours to 7 days capital cities, 325 cities we are giving forecast, capital cities. Forecast on demand also it is given for tourist food, non-aviation nowcast to Delhi, to 3 hourly nowcast for thunderstorm and sector specific also. These are public weather and multi-hazard warnings also we are given. This is an example, multi-hazard warning for cyclone, storm surge, coastal inundation, heavy rainfall, snow, fog, heat and cold wave, thunder, squall, etc. In 2006, we used to issue text-only bulletin, but now it is text-cum-graphic bulletin. 24 hours warning to 5 days. 24 earlier it was 24 hours warning, now it has been extended. Enhanced to 5 days warning. Earlier it was subdivisional warning, now it has come down to district level warning and simple warning to partial impact based warning. And we all know that in the recent during the recent forecast of the cyclones, IMD has also given the impact forecasting also, not only impact based forecast, impact forecasting also IMD has given. And this is example of severe weather warning, that is heat wave and thunder squall. It is given in this way, you see pictorially and text also in a tabular form. Color code we are using to express the severity. As I already told you, sector specific for a forecast, these are the sectors. And these are one of the important severe weather services, cyclone warning service of India Meteorological Department. It is a very worldwide known. Its main job is monitoring and prediction of cyclones over the North Indian oceans, and it issues tropical weather outlook and cyclone advisories to the WMO escape panel countries like Bangladesh, Myanmar, Thailand, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Oman, and Pakistan. That means what I mean to say, cyclone warning service of India Meteorological Department takes care of these countries also. And also tropical advisories for aviation as per the guidelines of ICAO. Tropical cyclone warning, there are different stages are there. Pre-cyclone watch, cyclone alert, cyclone warning, post-landfall output at, outlook and dewarning. Pre-cyclone watch, it is issued 72 hours in advance, indicating formation of a cyclonic disturbance and its potential intensity, potential to intensify into a cyclone. Then cyclone alert, it is issued 2 days back, that is 48 hours in advance, indicating the expected adverse weather conditions. Then cyclone warning is issued 24 hours advance, indicates latest position of the tropical cyclone, its intensity, time, point of rainfall, etc. Then post landfall outlook, it is issued about 12 hours before landfall till cyclone force winds prevail, and it is given to district collectors of the interior district besides the coastal areas are also informed. And finally, a de-warning message is also issued when the tropical cyclone weakens and have no adverse impact. And during cyclone warning, so many bulletins, warnings are issued. You can see sea area bulletin, coastal weather bulletin, fisheries warning, all these things. And this is a recent success story, remarkable improvement in the prediction of the super cyclone Amphan. It was very, very accurate prediction by India Meteorological Department and other institutions of MOES like IITM, INCOIS, etc., NCMR, FWF. And it is now forecast standard is at par, even better than other leading centers. And there are certain success stories you must have read in the newspaper. The WMO applauds India Meteorological Department for its prediction of cyclone Amphan. And not only that, in the tweet, the Honorable Secretary has written hearty congratulations to India Meteorological Department for accurate forecast and warning for cyclone Amphan, helped to save precious lives, perfect textbook predictions. It's a very important statement, perfect textbook prediction, thanks to observation, model, expertise, proud of IMD, excellent work, also by NDRF, central and state government managing crisis. These are the track which I have already shown. And also we know that one of the important activities of India Meteorological Department is issue of long range prediction all India June to September rainfall. This is issued in April, then it is updated for all India June to September rainfall in June, then all India monthly July August rainfall, this is also given in June, then all India second half of season August September rainfall, that is given in July, and all India monthly September rainfall, this is again in August, and all these informations are this is given for all India, and you can see for the four homogeneous region we give June to September rainfall for four geographical region, and this is given in the month of June. So it may be concluded from my very primitive and humble talk, following conclusion I can make that although it is a trivial thing, weather plays a very important role in our day-to-day life for all sectors, and it is weather forecast is very, very essential to all, from common public, different societal sectors, planners, policymakers, administrative authorities, even to the communities also. Observational system plays a very important role in preparation of the initial condition at desired level of accuracy, because there is a saying that forecast is a function of initial condition. Rather, forecast is a continuous function of the initial condition. So we can understand, if we cannot provide accurate initial condition, very good initial condition, so we cannot expect a very good forecast. And we all have understood, we all can realize that better initial condition, accurate initial condition we can have from a better observation system. So observation system plays a very important role, and realizing this itself, you must have seen that radar network in India Meteorological Department has increased very, very significantly. Earlier, what type of radar is there? Now we are having Doppler weather data, their resolution, so many informations we are getting from the Doppler weather data, and it is covering the entire coast. If one radar leaves, then another radar takes up. And we have also seen that broadly there are three types of forecast, rather I should say not three, four types, synoptic, statistical, dynamical, and dynamical comes statistical forecast. However, considering accommodating of uncertainty, dynamical statistical method EPS appears to be better. In IMD, DSS, decision support system, takes care of all information available from observation, different model forecast, and the expert opinion to finalize with a consensus forecast. Because every day in IMD, we are from 10:30 to about 12:30, video conferencing meeting is there. In this video conferencing meeting, all the heads of forecasting offices are present, even many times DGIMD present, and there all inputs are discussed. All inputs means inputs from all observational system, inputs from all forecasting system, and inputs from all expertise are considered, and considering all those things, a consensus forecast is developed, and this consensus forecast is issued to all over India. Thanks for your very kind and patient hearing.
Thank you, Dr. Somna Dattaji. It's a very interesting talk, very basic talk, taking us through evolution of forecast from history to today, and mentioning several observational efforts made on that. So we have some questions for you kept in your chat window. So kindly switch to your video mode and answer them.
Okay. Lots of diseases. Question number one is, lots of diseases are now weather prone. How do you use the weather science moving in this direction. So now one thing I am telling you, recently in India Meteorological Department at Pune, there is a division. The name of the division is Climate Application and and User Interface and users group, climate in users group, climate climate information users group. So now actually in this group prepares every week a product based on some information available from WMO literature about certain infectious disease, for example malaria, because in the WMO literature it is available that what is the transmission window as far as temperature is concerned for malaria, what is the transmission window for the rainfall. Okay, so now India Meteorological Department every week issued your MME base, your that is extended range prediction for weekly, 2 weekly. So now now that prediction is examined, and after examining it is found out over which region temperature, expected temperature or anticipated temperature falls within this window, and that is being indicated. But IMD is not at all attempting to predict the disease because it is not the mandate of IMD. Question number two. Now the monsoon over India is almost active. If we get a good rain spells, do this kind of weather has any impact on COVID-19? No comment at all, because I have no idea about that. What are the plans for modernization of observation and forecasting systems in India? Now plan is your to into meso network. We are already in that process. Meso network, synoptic scale network we are having. So meso network, that means we are trying to increase the observatory by use of more and more automatic weather stations, automatic rain gauge, etc. Are there any open source models available for weather forecast? WRF, Weather Research and Advanced, WRF model is open source model, it is available. Why can't we use direct observation? Why do you need data pre-processing? Why? Because what happened, you know, I am telling you, model requires the true value, true, quote-unquote, true value of a meteorological variable at a given time, at a given place. Now, if I ask someone, what is the true value of that meteorological parameter at that place? Immediately we may say, I will just go and take the observation. That means we are thinking, whatever I am observing, that is the true value. No, it is not so. Because if someone again goes, then he or she may find a different value. So that means by observation, we are trying to estimate the true value of that particular field. So therefore we can and similarly whatever observations we are getting, whether it is man-made or machine-made, they are nothing but the estimate of that true value. Now that estimate may contains bias and other errors, and if those bias and those other errors are allowed to remain, then those errors may give rise to the birth of some spurious disturbance. Technically, we say spurious gravity wave. And those spurious disturbance, with time, they can progress and they can amplify. And by this, they are most likely to spoil the forecast, entire forecast. That's why it requires preprocessing.
Thank you, sir, for your talk.
Okay, thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thanks to Secretary MOS, DG IND, and main thing is thanks to all the audience who have kindly, with patience, they have heard my talk. I know this is a very, very primitive talk. And another one thing, I am not an expert in weather forecasting because I don't have any experience in operational weather forecasting. But since I am teaching for a long time, I know a bit about the science of the weather forecasting. Based on that knowledge itself, I just attempted to make this presentation, make this lecture. I don't know how much it has disappointed you, how much you have satisfied you. Thank you. Namaskar. Thank you.